It's not important just that your customers see your message, but they need to be in the right state of mind to receive your message. I give you one other example from IKEA. IKEA, actually, they were advertising a castle bed for kids on the radio in the morning. Why? Because most of the people were going to work at the same time, so the reach was the highest ever. Makes sense, no? They were reaching tons of people. What was the problem? Try to guess.
They were nervous because of the traffic. They didn't receive the message.
Mm-hmm. Might be. Other ideas?
They were thinking about job and not about kids.
That's it. I mean, when you drive towards your job, you are already in the mindset, I'm working. And you start organizing your day. I need to do this, I need to do this, I need to do this. The radio is just a background. Mm-hmm. You don't really pay attention to it. So they were paying a lot because it was the most expensive spot. Mm-hmm. Because you need to reach tons of people. But no one was listening. Just by moving the same message after work, when people were coming back, they were paying less because not everybody finishes work at the same hour. But it was much more effective. Because once you finish work and you are driving towards your home, you start thinking about your kids. So your kids, your wife, your husband, and so on. So the message was much more powerful. So when you plan the execution, think about not only where your target is, but in which mindset your target is, okay?
Guys, do you have any questions so far? Anything that you would like to deep dive more? Okay. If you do anyway, also do it also after this class, please feel free to email us. If you're curious about something, we can send you some materials also so that you can go through it more in detail. Okay.
I mean, all the slides you've seen here, you will receive. And actually, you will receive some additional one because we also have included some cheat sheet, sort of, that basically are a very quick sum up that you can print it and keep with you in the office, like this.
Now, when it comes to communication, yes.
Often means when we see some advertising that we cannot understand. This means that it's not the message is not for our typology or I cannot give you an example now, but I remember some advertisers that I'm looking at it and cannot understand why they want exactly they want to sell.
This is a very good point, guys. I think number one, it can be that yes, that message is not for you. So it can be that maybe it doesn't resonate to you, but it resonates to someone else. It can be. So now, one of the key things moving on is that every time you look at advertising, you should ask yourself, who is the target? Also, when they send you something and you need to say, do I like it or not, don't look at it from your own perspective, but always put yourself in the shoes of the consumer. It can also be that that message is so generic because they try to be appealing for everyone, that in the end, they end up being relevant for no one. That's also something very common. And other times, it's just that the message is not clear enough. They should have done a better job. I am a big fan of the KISS rule. You know the KISS rule? No one? Keep it simple and stupid. Yeah. So let's try to be as much straightforward as possible. And I'm going to say one more thing. I'm going to quote my friend and colleague, Luca. Once he said, Matteo, I understood that we live in a bubble. Usually, the people that are in this room, they have quite a high level of education, of culture. The world is not like this. Sometimes we need to be very, very straightforward. and less sometimes more. And I'm gonna say something, I'm gonna dedicate this to Roman. Because yesterday he quoted Churchill. And I'm gonna quote him again. Once during his speech, he said two things. He started by saying, if I would have had more time, I would have written a shorter speech. So sometimes, be concise. The second one is about the cultural differences. And it was when he had to make the speech between Japan and US. And he said, if I had only in front of me an American public, I would have started with a joke. If I would have in front of me only a Japanese people, I would have started with some apologies. But since it's mixed, I'm gonna start by apologizing for not making a joke. This is to come back to the Roman, this was for you. Coming back also to the cultural behavior stuff. Okay, but now, so I was saying that sometimes we can make mistakes in our communication and we need to be aware of those mistakes. Here I have 9 different kind of mistakes that I want to bring your attention to. Let's start from the mistake number one. The mistake number one is not being meaningful for your target. This one was quite recent. This was from Pandora in Milan. There was this big picture inside the metro station of Milan that says like this, an iron, a pair of pyjamas, an apron, a Pandora bracelet. What do you think will make her happy? Why do you think why do you think this was very bad perceived by the Pandora consumers? What is the mistake?
Wrong target.
It's like iron pair of pyjamas, like
stereotyping
the women.
And the
target of Pandora is butterflies, that they want to be independent, that they are self-confident, that they believe in women emancipation, they believe in gender equality. And what are you doing? You're going to communicate this? Are you crazy?
Offending.
So remember always to be meaningful for your target.
Pandora is a global brand.
Yes.
But this is the local communication.
Yes.
Somebody should approve it from global. That's the way how we have to.
Yes. And they did approve it and they did the wrong job. Why? Why? Because they didn't know the local culture.
Yeah. But still, I don't know. This is not about the
local about
the culture for me.
What is it about?
This is the
woman. Is about being off strategy, being not knowing your target group.
Pandora is the same everywhere, I think.
What we saw before, no? Before we said that there are peacocks, there were fancy peacocks, and we call it stars and chimneys. Yeah. So just like there are butterflies, Chardonnay girls, Young White Turks, every country has a different target group with different dynamics. Now, if the target is butterflies in Italy, let's make sure that we know what is the context. Let's make sure that we create something that is relevant for them.
Understand, but can be so different, these butterflies in every country to have this?
No.
You have a good point. The point here is sometimes the creative agency loves an idea, pitches to you, and then wow, cool, they convince you and you say approve, and it goes on print. So you fall in love with the executional idea and you forget about the strategy, and that's a big mistake. In this case, it's completely off strategy. I agree with you, it's not aligned neither with Italian strategy of Pandora, neither with global strategy of Pandora. probably the guy of the agency was really good at selling this idea in the client meeting.
Yeah.
But what's the target group for this?
Yeah. The butterfly.
No.
You think so?
Yes. For Pandora or for with the message?
For this
kind
campaign.
Of message.
Yeah, message.
For this campaign, yeah.
Not for men, because
have someone who hiring for them. So it is.
This is not for butterfly.
Yeah, not only butterfly. Not the global butterfly.
No. I know. I mean, this globally for Italia, Pandora, the communication, the aspiration portrait is butterfly. If you ask me, what is this message for?
For men.
It's for men.
Traditional. The board refused it and sent it back. So in order to make it relevant for the board of the company, she interviewed the daughter and the wife of the president of the board, and she asked them if they were feeling comfortable with like the images of all the models on the magazines. And when the member of the board seen the reaction of his wife and his kid, he got really like a goosebump, and he bought into the ideas. And then the Real Beauty campaign got approved. Why? Because she understood exactly who she had in front, and she made it personal. She tailor-made the message according to the segment that the person was. And she sold also internally this idea. So you can actually use also this tailor-made sales approach, not only with clients, but even internally in your own meetings.
You guys are familiar with the campaign Real Beauty, no?
Yeah.
So basically, instead of showing models, to showing real girls, normal girls of every day.
So segment Roman and try to sell him stuff.
But that was not a successful campaign. Yeah.
It was.
Massively successful.
One of the best campaigns ever. Like Real Beauty. Next. Quite simple, but very true, it happened. Make sure to not do spelling mistakes.
Public school.
No, 15 best things about our public schools. I probably am not going to send you my kids there, that's for sure. Here, a tasty contradiction. Miller, they probably won't tell themselves a bit more Spanish. And this one was amazing. This was, I'm with Meet. Meet was was a candidate running to the US government, and they did this campaign. It was full of all over the US. It was saying a better America instead of better America. So of course, he didn't win. Next. This one is probably one of my favorite, which is treating your consumers as fools. This one is like strawberry lemonade forever for a limited time. Okay, something's wrong. Why pay 10 cents for a barbecue chicken? It's only 99.88. Save the 12 cents.
Buy three of the price of two and get one free.
Okay, next. This one we talk about, you know, the Fiat, the Ford Pinto, very bad mistake. Right after Nova, so come on, Ford, you should learn better. Next. This one. Cultural differences. Did you know about this one?
No.
You talk about Pringles. I love it. Genius. The people from Kellogg's, they were genius. They said, okay, let's give something, let's create something for Ramadan. An extra display for Ramadan, let's put it outside all the Tesco near to the mosque. Amazing idea, only one problem. They do it with a bacon flavor, and they cannot eat bacon. They cannot eat pork, it's against their religion. Fantastic mistake.
It was pretty orbico, yeah.
Power it was orbico. No, no, no.
It was UK.
It was UK, it was UK.
Who approved this?
Approved. So basically here, guys, whenever it comes to communication, whenever you want to create some communication, remember always two things. So remember what is the your target group concentration, and also what is the mindset of your target group in that specific channel. So you want to make sure that you are here on the top right where they have an high receptivity and you also reach your target group, top right. So I always keep this in mind. Whenever you need to decide on which channel you want to focus, you want to invest, try yourself this chart and make sure that you are on that top right quadrant. Next is a campaign by Das Auer. It was Wagner, okay? I'm pretty sure that probably you know it, and it's a fantastic, fantastic example on how to communicate in a way that is unconventional, breaking the rules of communication, and make sure that that message punch into your target.
The girl you will see is a famous makeup artist from Norway. Yes. So she will do the makeup.
Hey guys! So today I'm doing another tutorial. I'm sort of doing my look of like my haute couture, like avant-garde version of the stars. Today we're using this palette. It is absolutely gorgeous. And we're also going to use some rhinestones, as you can tell. These are the rhinestones. Absolutely. Yeah, I love you. That is what I'm going to do today. And if you want to know how I did this, so please keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is take a really nice dark brown eyeshadow. What you're going to do is apply this to your lower lash line. Like that. Okay, now I'm going to take a really nice light highlighting color, and you're going to highlight the lid with this. Apply this to your eyelids. Okay, now you're just going to take the glue, apply it to your eyes like that, and you're taking your rhinestone.
How many of you girls try?
All.
Have you ever put makeup while driving?
Yes. Of course.
This is for you.
I'm sitting in
the
car, not driving. We don't.
It gets you this message, no? Probably you won't forget this advertising. And hopefully, after this, you will try to not do your makeup and drive because it's really dangerous.
I mean, too bad. You came back.
And especially the viewer of this were completely in the mindset of putting makeup because they are learning how to put a new type of makeup. So it really hits in the right moment.
Is this one digital campaign or on air?
Digital
campaign. Digital.
Thanks.
Show that.
This one.
This we kind of touched with Roma yesterday. I don't know if you want to cover because at the end the students don't really know the Google's quiz case. Up to you guys. Okay. Very briefly, basically, following with the Google Street. We checked the communication where you activated it, no? So, Sheshkoliada, Mutikino, sponsorship with matches played by the young team of Bologna and Warsaw, T-Mobile Extra Class matches again with kids, Football Academy of Bologna and Warsaw, and point of purchase activation. Now, in terms of concentration of the target, many of them make sense because actually Scogliata, it's kind of fitting the healthy lifestyle because there are kids playing, doing sports.
Scogliata is kindergarten.
Yeah. In Multichino, actually, with the cartoon, when the kids were going to watch a movie for kids. So in terms of concentration, we are fine. The issue here was more about the actual message. So the actual message was all the time about super function. It was basically 100% fruit, without added sugar, without conservants. How can break that message through the kids? Nothing. Or again, in the point of purchase, it might be relevant for the months, yes, but there was the other barrier there. Fruit mousse, new to the Polish market, population still not educated that that is really healthy, seems very artificial. So for us, the key issue here in the communication was, first of all, the population was still not well educated about the product. Second, the message was not breaking through, because it was only functional and not tailor-made to the specific occasions. So what it gives me back. It was the same exact message all over. Okay?
Good. Now we move into digital marketing. So it's impossible to not talk about digital nowadays, especially when it comes to create more engaging communication. So let's start about digital, let's start talking about digital. And the way I want to start, just to put you in perspective, is by showing you this video that highlights the importance of digital nowadays. Quite impressive, eh? I really like these videos because they really help us to understand the power of social media nowadays. So I'm really glad that today, now here, we start thinking a little bit in a different way, a bit more digital way. What that means is that I'm going to show you basically some how digital has evolved during the year. I'm going to start with a quote from Seth Godin that says, marketing is no longer about stuff that you make, but about the stories you tell. So you need to be able to create stories by using your digital platform. Now guys, I'm going to show you, there is this Italian guy, probably you're not going to have a lot of fun with it, but if you're Italian, it's very funny because this guy is telling you, is telling us from ages that is the last day to get this discount. Since I was 9 years old, I remember this guy that is still saying, today is the last time, is the last day to have this 8% discount. But the way of doing communication needs to evolve. We cannot be this, and in fact, this guy now is not as successful as he was before. But here, what I want to show you is the importance of telling a story. Creating brand content. And the interesting part is that when you create brand content, your brand is not the key. It's part of the story. It's part of the story. Let's look now at this case study from Ibis, you know? Let's see how they create a story behind their brand.
Ibis is a worldwide chain of budget hotels. Since 2012, Ibis has a new bed in its rooms, behind a suite bed. Thanks to this innovative total comfort bed, you can be sure to get the perfect night's sleep at Ibis Hotels. But how to prove this without getting sleepy? We put the bed to the test in a crazy extreme adventure with the best props to make it really entertaining and extreme. What happened next is now part of the history of sleep.
Up for the talk and sleep in his bed or die trying.
An epic 15-minute documentary. A colossal product demo. A fantastic amount of additional content. Gigantic immersive HTML5 experience. A heroic act of sleep.
Itself, the hotel, but they focus on giving a story. The story that starts from the fact that their beds are really the most comfortable if you want to have a nice rest.
Ibis.
Now let's talk on how to create a digital strategy. A digital strategy is based on two key factors. The first one is content. The second one is context. So any digital strategy starts from these two things, content and context. Now, how do you create this the content? and which channel do you use, which kind of activities do you do online, is by seven key phases. The first one is local listings. Any idea what local listings is? No one? I think the terminology is a bit difficult, very specific, but it's something that you all know. It's basically when you have Google Pages, or when you have, you want to make sure that if someone looks for you, you are actually online. The second thing is website and apps. So if you want to be called digitally, nowadays you need to have a website, and also sometimes can be very useful also to have an app. The third thing is SEO and SEM, search engine optimization, and search engineering marketing. What is the difference between the two? What's a SEO? Okay, search engine optimization, but what does it mean?
If you search for
you, easier to find.
Find the keywords.
You're higher on the list.
You need to define the keywords.